If you're a Zone 9B gardener, you know that we have hot summers, but we also have a super long growing season, which means we got to take advantage of it. But that doesn't mean we can plant everything all year long. We should plant certain crops during certain times of the year when they're going to thrive. So stick around for this video because I'm going to be sharing three must-have tips if you're a Zone 9B gardener. I'm Audrey from Audrey's Little Farm, and around here it's all about finding joy in the simple things. Okay, so my first tip is to plant vegetables that are known for thriving in the heat. This is going to be your eggplant, summer squashes, cucumbers, okra, green beans, and tomatoes. But for instance, tomatoes are a warm weather crop, but not every variety will thrive in the heat. So what this means is when you're picking out the tomatoes to grow, look up varieties that are specifically known for thriving in the heat. These are probably going to most likely be hybrid varieties, and there's a lot out there that are specifically bred to tolerate high temperatures, humidity, diseases, you know, things like that. So that's the kind of stuff you need to look into before planting things in Zone 9B because our summers do get super harsh. My second tip is to plant your cool weather crops such as broccoli, cauliflower, carrots, lettuces, and things like that in fall instead of spring. Unless you start those vegetables early in a greenhouse and you get a harvest early enough before it gets too warm. The problem is if you start a lot of those crops by seed, it warms up too fast in spring that it ends up making the plant go to bolt and you don't get a harvest. So if you've ever seen your lettuce one day just shoot up high and go straight to seed, it's because it warmed up too fast and the plant couldn't fully mature before it got warm enough. That's why these are cool weather crops, because they thrive in the cool weather. And unfortunately, our springs get warm too fast that they don't really do well in the spring. Okay, and tip number three, which is probably most important, is to water deeply and slowly. And so what this means is instead of just misting your plant real quick and creating a puddle of water around the plant, you want to let the water just drip so it just soaks right through the soil and gets way down to the roots and really drenches the soil beneath the plant. It doesn't really matter if the surface of the ground is wet. What really matters is that the water gets down deep to the roots and continues going through the soil to actually train the root systems to go deep. This is going to create super strong plants with strong root systems. And so when it does get hot, you have a much healthier and mature plant. And so what I do is I have everything set up on a mister system and I let my misters run slowly for about 20 minutes every other day. And of course, when I start off, when the plants are small, I just do about 5 minutes every other day. But then as the plants get more mature and larger, I increase the amount of water per day. And I still just only go about every other day, unless it's really hot, then I will water every day. But since I do this from day one, the plants are strong. And so even when it's in the hundreds, I can still go every other day watering for a long period of time because it just waters the plants so good. And because I know how difficult it can be gardening in Zone 9, I actually created an entire gardening guide for Zone 9B specifically, and it has all of your seed starting dates, when to transplant your plants outside, when to plant them by seed outside, which ones should even be started by seed and which ones should never be started by seed, a list of heat-tolerant vegetables, a list of all your cool season crops and warm season crops, and when you should plant each kind. And you can get it instantly. It's a PDF download, but I print it and I have it in a binder and I just keep it out in the garden, and it makes gardening so much easier. And I want you to have this too, because I just know that having this garden plan is gonna make this year's garden so much better for you. So be sure to check the link below, get your copy today, and then let me know how you like it. I hope you have a great day and I will see you in the next video.